Have you ever wanted to learn Unreal Engine but gave up because the software seemed a bit overwhelming? Well, in this series, I'll be learning Unreal Engine 5 cinematics using 3D community challenges like the ones Ponisha has hosted so that we're forced to execute a vision from start to finish.
For those of you who don't know,
Ponisha is a YouTuber famous for his 3D work, his tutorials, and some of you might also know him from the Corridor Crew channel.
Look at that neck! Dude, look at that neck snap!
And he's also known for hosting massive 3D community challenges where artists from all over the world submit their renders and a montage is created with the top 100 renders. Over the past 2 years, Ponisha has held 7 community challenges, the latest being the boss fight challenge, which I recently created with some basic knowledge of Unreal Engine. But I clearly still have a long way to go. Okay, so I'll cross out the boss fight challenge for now, and maybe we can revisit it after the series is complete at the very end and create a new one with all the new learnings along the way. So it'll be fun to compare the before and after. In this series, we'll be tackling a new challenge every episode, and we're going to be learning everything off of YouTube tutorials.
Yes, sir.
There are plenty of YouTube tutorials, but they're all over the place and kind of spread out, so it can be difficult finding exactly what you need. I'll be linking all the tutorials I use in the description below. I'll also add the different foundational tutorials I used prior to this, so if you're entirely new to Unreal Engine, that's where I'd recommend you begin. Before going any further, consider liking the video and subscribing. It would really help out the channel and allow me to make more videos like this. So without further ado, let's get into the first challenge, Parallel Dimensions. Here's the template for the challenge. First, I'll open up our Unreal Engine template file. There isn't one, but that's no problem. We'll just create our own. I'll use a Mixamo walking character, drop him in and roughly match the camera to the template. And now we have our template ready. This feudal Japan set from the free Quixel Megascan library is honestly incredible, so we have to use this. Now let's look at some references and create a rough sketch for our scene layout. So the goal is to create a peaceful, ambient feudal Japan scene. I found this cool Japanese castle on Sketchfab. Now let's drop everything in. Let's create a path, add street lanterns. Next, I'll add some cliffs and mountains. Change the color to match the scene. Now we need to texture the castles. I'll download some surface materials from the Megascans library and add it to the houses. Next, we'll add the lights and lanterns. The lights inside the house weren't showing up properly in the path tracer, so I just created an emissive material and added it to the doors. It's time to add some trees and sculpt the landscape for a river. To paint the landscape, I created a new material that allows me to switch between 3 surface materials. But there's one problem. The surface tiling looks horrible. Alright, we can fix that.
Nice.
We still need to populate the scene a little more. We'll add a well, some rocks, an embankment, and finally grass. I'll be using this free Paragon character, but we can come back to him once we're done with the environment. It's time to move on to the lighting. We'll get an HDRI in. Here's where I get my HDRIs from. It's free and there are tons of options. And I'll tint the light to make it look more like a sunset. I switched out the mountains in the background and added a temple atop one of the peaks. Then place a snow texture on the meshes. Next, let's add some fog to the mountains to create some depth. I'm using William Foscher's Easy Fog plugin, which is a hack and I'd recommend you guys to check it out. Moving on to some Niagara simulations, we need some incense smoke. Then add some birds in the distance. For the river, I'm adding a plane and simply dropping a water material on it from the Rural Australia pack on the marketplace, which works surprisingly well in the Path Tracer. To add candles in the lanterns, I'm following this tutorial to create the candle flames. Then we'll place the candles into the lanterns. Let's see what it looks like in the Path Tracer. So I just learned cascade systems aren't supported in the Path Tracer. I gave up and bought the Candle Flame Niagara system for $5. And now we have our candles lit. Then I added some samurai guarding the house with an idle breathing animation. And another samurai walking. Let's move on to our hero character. I'll have to retarget the Mixamo animation to the Paragon asset first. And now we can render. The cloth simulation is going crazy bouncing around and I couldn't solve it. I just removed the cloth altogether and rendered again. Added some ambient sound effects, and here we have our final render. But wait, doing all of this for a 3-second render doesn't feel right. So I'll add another shot of the hero character entering the scene, teleporting in with a lightning strike. I'll place some more trees in the background and use this level start animation. Then I'll add the lightning and After Effects. And now we have our final render.